Welcome back to The Sideline. I'm Spencer Fowler.
I'm Bethany Mock. After a long winter break, we're ready to get back in the swing of things with our Torero Spring Sports.
This past Sunday was Super Bowl Sunday, and wow, was it a game. The Atlanta Falcons and their number one ranked offense took on the New England Patriots and their number one ranked defense. Aside from all the hilarious commercials, the first half of the game wasn't especially entertaining. The Falcons took a commanding 21-3 lead going into halftime and looked to cruise for the second half. But four-time MVP Tom Brady had something to say about that. The Patriots scored 31 unanswered points and converted 2 two-point conversions in the final quarter of regulation to tie the game at 28, sending it to overtime. The Pats won the coin toss and elected to receive the ball to start OT. Tom Brady proceeded to lead his team down the field with precision, and running back James White leapt into the end zone to cap off the drive and seal the game for the Patriots as they defeated the Falcons 34-28. Not only was this the first Super Bowl to ever go into overtime, the comeback was huge. The Patriots' 25-point comeback was the largest comeback in Super Bowl history and marked New England's fifth Super Bowl win under coach Bill Belichick. Tom Brady was named the Super Bowl MVP for the fourth time in his career, adding to an already remarkable legacy. What a game. In studio today, we have first-year student Olivia Quinn, who was lucky enough to attend Super Bowl 51. Welcome, Olivia.
Thank you.
So, how exactly were you able to get tickets to Super Bowl 51?
Yeah, okay. So my uncle is actually the head coach for the Atlanta Falcons.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. So you're related to Dan Quinn.
Yeah. So he's my dad's brother.
So were you able to speak with Coach Quinn at all prior to the game?
Actually, yes. So we arrived in Houston on Friday, and on Saturday, we actually got to go to their practice. And then after the practice was over, all the family members got to go on the field and like find either their player or the coach that they knew and just like chat a little bit before the big game on Sunday.
Wow. Could you just give me like a brief summary of what the entire experience of what the Super Bowl was?
Totally. So we woke up on Sunday from the hotel and then took a family bus to the stadium. And there was a tailgate before the game with just Falcons players' families and coaches' families. And then after that, we headed to the stadium and every seat was filled. It was like different than a normal game I've been to because the mood was more serious. Like it wasn't as rowdy as like a normal game. And then during the game, it was like very intense, and we were like very happy and relaxed. Like the first half of the game, because we were up like 28-3. But then it wasn't boring in the end because we like lost that lead. And then in the fourth quarter, it was devastating. It went into overtime. Like, and that was the first time in history.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. But that fourth quarter in overtime was incredible. Like it was one of the, it was the largest comeback in Super Bowl history.
Crazy.
How was the mood just in the stadium changing throughout the fourth quarter in overtime?
Yeah. Well, obviously like we were around Patriots fans and Falcons fans, but all the fans were like really nice to each other about it.
So thank you again so much for coming into studio today. It was great to hear everything. And yeah, thank you from everyone here at The Sideline.
Of course.
Thanks again for coming into studio today, Olivia. What an awesome experience.
I would have loved to have been at that game. It really was one for the books. On February 4th, 2017, the USD baseball team hosted its 15th annual For the Love of the Game Gala. There were over 100 guests in attendance, with supporters, family, friends, and prominent alumni in the crowd. During the gala, past and present Toreros were celebrated, including A.J. Griffin, Samu Solis, Chris Bryant, and the USD baseball team of 2007. A.J. Griffin of the Texas Rangers was recognized after becoming an American League West Division champion in 2016, and Washington Nationals LHP Samu Solis was also recognized for earning the title of 2016 National League East Division champion. Though Chris Bryant was not in attendance at this year's gala, his agent Kurt Stillwell came to speak on his behalf. After being drafted from USD in 2013, Bryant has gone on to become one of the best current players in the MLB with the Chicago Cubs. Not only did he earn the title of 2016 National League MVP, but he also joined the Cubs in winning the World Series. Also in attendance was the USD's 2007 baseball team. They returned to their alma mater to celebrate the 10-year anniversary of their WCC championship and their first ever national seed and regional host in WCC baseball. What a great way to see how far our Toreros have come. This year, the baseball team will kick off its season against Vanderbilt at home in Fowler Park. After the three-game weekend series, the Toreros will participate in the second annual Tony Gwynn Classic. Oregon, Notre Dame, and Seton Hall are just a few teams who will be joining us in sunny San Diego from February 24th through the 26th. Tickets are available for purchase at the box office in Fowler Park.
The softball team headed out to Tempe, Arizona to kick off their season. They faced top teams from across the nation, including Cal Poly, ASU, Stanford, Fresno State, and Seattle University.
Hey guys, I'm Sarah. I'm a junior on the softball team, and we're on our way to Arizona State for the first weekend of the year. We're playing Cal Poly, Arizona State, Fresno State, Seattle, and
Stanford.
So here we go. Follow us as we go throughout this weekend. We just got off the bus in Arizona, and we're super excited to play Cal Poly ASU tomorrow.
Hi, I'm Kelly Clanton, and it's game day, so we gotta get our hair done. If you don't look good on game day, how can you play? LB is our resident hairstylist, so she's hooking me up with the braids today.
Softball will travel to Cathedral City, California on Friday, February 17th to play Utah Valley and Kent State, and they'll face Arkansas and Cal Poly on Saturday. Finally, the Toreros will return home to play against Cal on February 19th at 11:30 a.m. Good luck, Toreros.
The men's basketball suffered two unfortunate losses against LMU and St. Mary's. They're looking to bounce back on the road. Toreros will be on the road and headed to Provo, Utah to play the BYU Cougars on February 16th at 8 p.m. They'll play in Santa Clara on February 18th at 8 p.m. against the Santa Clara Broncos.
Women's basketball also took two losses against LMU and St. Mary's, but are ready to get back on the court. Toreros will be taking on BYU at home in the JCP on Thursday, February 16th at 6 p.m. They'll stay in town for the weekend and will play Santa Clara on Saturday, February 18th at 2 p.m. Make sure to stop by the Torero ticket office near the JCP to get your game day tickets.
With the warm San Diego sun shining, it's tennis time. Women's tennis took a 4-0 win against CSUN after a close 4-3 match loss against Hawaii. Men's tennis claimed a 4-2 win against SDSU, and they will be traveling to Rancho Santa Fe, California, February 13th through 14th to participate in the Compression Invitational. The Toreros will return home for a match against UNC Wilmington at 1 p.m. on Saturday, February 18th, and will face Fresno State and Hawaii on Sunday, February 19th.
It's sunny and 75 in San Diego, so perfect weather to be in the water. February 15th through the 17th, women's swim will head to the championships in Los Angeles at East LA College. Just keep swimming, Toreros. Women's rowing will be out on the bay Saturday, February 18th. They'll have a scrimmage with SDSU, UCSB, and OCC.
There are tons of sports games to get to this week, so make sure to head to the ticket office and get your free student ticket to support your Toreros.
If you're unable to attend the game but still want to watch it from the sideline, follow us on social media.
That's all for this week. Signing off, I'm Bethany Mock.
And I'm Spencer Fowler. Thanks for joining us on the sideline.